All right, hello everyone and welcome back to my Fallout 4 miniseries of The Forest, where today, don't worry folks, no weird music on this one. In fact, we're already on the classical radio station. I'm still so annoyed with how that all went down for the previous episode. Got the video all done. The music choice by the mod maker was magnificent. It was perfectly atmospheric and wonderful, but then when uploaded, YouTube's copyright claim system. And the worst part, it wasn't even the actual owner of the music, because of course it wasn't. It's YouTube's copyright claim system. So I do apologize for the now obvious to me poor choice in the music I put on top of it. I didn't think much of it, but it was like really late at night when I had to do that, and I was frustrated and pissed at YouTube, so I just kind of put it there real quick. Now I know that was the wrong choice, but we're good now. There will not be any weird music. We just got the classic radio to continue on with our adventure here, which I'm still very excited about. I'm liking the story it's building up so far. I'm liking the world. Now, one thing, it does look like it may start storming soon, so what I actually think I'm going to do, because you guys did have a very good point, a couple of you in the comments, on the beacon, that I didn't notice it when I was hoping for it to go into the map, but it may have added a miscellaneous quest. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to set up shop here. We are going to place our encampment at this little town, and this is where our base of operations is going to be for the time being. So let's actually set ourselves up here, because it has the most flat open ground without any weird bits and bobs around. So let's drop ourselves a tent. Where's my tent? There it is. Drop that. Beautiful. Actually, that's a pretty good spot for it. We'll drop ourselves a fire. There we are. Lovely. Oh, that dropped right on top of me. Okay. Well, let's drop in front of it a chair, because, you know, gotta have a nice chair to sit in. Well, sitting it, that did it right there. Move. Move. Ooh, no. Ooh, move. Do you know what? Just, I'm gonna pick it up. Pick up. There we go. So turn this way in front of the fire. It's been so long since I've used this mod, I really don't remember how it all worked. There we go. We got our folding chair. What else we got here? What else did I bring? We got our cooking pot and a lantern. Now, I know we can actually place the lantern on here. So there we are. We put that inside. And we'll put the cooking pot on top of that. Can I actually do that from clicking on the fire? Yes, place cooking pot. Wonderful. Wonderful. So our camp is set up. We just have to place the beacon. And I'll add that like next to the tent here. There we go. And okay, yeah, so it was a miscellaneous quest thing. Thank you guys for pointing that out to me. So there we go. So we've got that on there now, so we can find our home here. Excellent. And let's do another thing you guys suggested. Because, well, you were wondering as well that the Protectron might be a vendor. And apparently there is a bug that if the Protectron takes, like, any kinetic damage, like, say, from the weird glitching skeleton in the floor, that it would become mad. Oh god, can I move the skeleton? I think the skeleton is stuck here forever. But let's try reviving the cashier Protectron. Revive. Oh god, what was it? Resurrect? There it is.
It's right there.
Ah, he's still mad at me. All right, fine. Never mind. It was worth a try. Oh, he is glitching around now. Okay. Hey, we got new stuff from him this time. We could farm him. No. All right, so he does appear potentially just to be an enemy. That's disappointing. I was really hoping he might be like the one vendor. But oh well, what are you gonna do? So I'm gonna double check these mailboxes here. So what we're gonna start out with today, now that we've gotten through those things, is reading the stuff that was in that mailbox. So there were a couple of different letters. Oh, and also, thank you to the commenter who pointed out that the caltrops and bear traps were from Far Harbor. It's been ages since I've been in Far Harbor, and I genuinely do not remember those being a thing. So thank you. I had no clue. Oh, it was many years ago we played through that, but alright, so let's get... Well, first, I'm gonna take this. Let's look at the threatening letter first. I'll do them one at a time so I don't lose track, let's be honest, because I would. So, threatening letter. Let's see. Oh yeah, all the pages from the church. I forgot about those. Alright, there we go. What do we got? Dear Mr. Anderson, what the hell is going on with you? Do you choose to avert your eyes from the struggle we local and most loyal hunters have to deal with? Those hikers have been scaring our wildlife long enough, but what's worse is the trash they produce. I recently found two plastic bags inside a deer's stomach. They can't go on for longer, or that can't go on for longer. We need our pelts and hides, and in the end, you need it too, as do our kids. Hank Miller, head of the Anthem Hunting Association, and don't even plan to turn our land into a nature reserve. Okay, so Hunter's not happy about the nature reserve. Concerned letter, I'm gonna guess from the hikers. All right, back up this way, and concerned letter. Lovely. Dear Mr. Henderson, do you not see the decline of tourism that has been going on for decades? Those backpackers that we've got to do exact... do not exactly have the money we need to sustain this town. Not where I thought this was going to go, but okay. Expand the railway, invest in our hotel. Just listen to the people and don't follow your plan to turn the western side into a nature reserve. So everyone is against the nature reserve, especially here Margaret Blunder. All right, so I thought it was going to be the backpackers defending, no, we can't stop the hikers. But no, it's these people going, yeah, no, the backpackers aren't enough. We need other things. All right, cool. So what's the last one? Letter from Robco. What do we got over here? Down to L. And boom. Dear Mr. Anderson, I recently gathered information that you are planning to turn parts of Anthem County into a nature reserve. Such an undertaking obviously takes a lot of oversight. Might I interest you in our new Ranger Protectron models? Of course. They now come with water-resistant plating and reduce noise as not to disturb local wildlife or even poachers. Okay, all right. I'm eagerly awaiting your response. Jordan Grange. All right, so Robco wants the reserve so they can sell their nature preserve protectrons that even poachers won't hear. Now that could be taken one of two ways, that they won't hear them coming to take them down, or yeah, the poachers won't notice, so you know, they can keep doing what they do. One of the two. Knowing Robco, it's probably the latter. Okay, so yeah, we've got ourselves a nice little base of operation. I really don't know what I'm supposed to be doing though at this point now. I mean, we know and should go and investigate the lake, but I don't know where said lake is. Alright, just the opening the other side of this door for convenience sake. Was there one of these buildings I could get on the second floor of? So we can maybe try and see around a bit. I think over here there was. I don't quite remember. And I think we got all the different things, though. Yeah, it was this if we glitched up there. If we glitched through this this window. Yep, definitely not supposed to be getting in here, but all right. We're in not much height, but it is still some. I guess we could follow the road. Oh, what the? We got wolves. We got wolves in them there hills. All right, so we can really only see in one direction here. That's all hills over there from the looks of it. Yeah, more hills that way. Yeah, I'm guessing the lake is probably going to be off in this direction because of the flatter terrain. All right, let's investigate. Let's go find out. All right, so back through the window. Yeah, I'm pretty sure we got all the lore bits we can here. I think. We got all the pages in there. We read everything in the mayor's office. We read the letters there. Let's just double check the mayor's office to make sure I didn't miss anything. So I know we read... Yeah, we got the stuff in his desk. Okay, we're good. All right, so... You know, it's actually getting dark now. Let's... Well, what time actually is it? Oh, It's, I did not mean to take a rat away then. It's 6:29. A little bit too early to camp, I'd say. So let's look at the immediate area around here. Nope, nothing there. Check the water tower. Check if anything else around here. Doesn't look it. Lots of stuff growing around the water tower, though. That's nice. Alright. Yeah, just looks like more forests. Oh, actually, it looks like it may kind of taper off with the mountains over in that area, too. I couldn't really tell where we were on the second floor earlier. But yeah, back here seems like this might be potentially the edge of the world with these hills. Oh, hi, wolf! Oh, you ran, huh? Well, bleed. And... oh, missed him. Oh, I wasn't reloaded? Come back, feral wolf. God, where'd he go? Well, I gotta find him. Gotta put him out of his misery. There we go. Wolf me. Oh, God, he had a friend. Cricket? Cool. Well, you die, too. And... okay. And boom. Oh, wait, one more. Ow, all right, yeah, you heard me a little bit there. There we go. Eh, I don't care for cave cricket meat. Oh god, did I just hear another thing? There's another thing! All right, you know what, you're gonna crit. Boom. I actually don't think I needed the crit on that one, but I did it. More wolf meat. We're gonna eat wolf tonight. All right, so yeah, we've got what looks like maybe the edge of the world here. Potentially. Let's scramble on up these rocks a little and see. Oop. Nope. I can't go that way. All right, yep, so this is the edge of the world. Oh, yeah, that's definitely the edge of the world over there. Beautiful. All right, yeah, it's starting to get foggy now, so I think that also might be another edge over there, so let's follow that a bit, and then we'll head back to camp and sleep for the night. I mean, come on, it's a camping mod. We've got to camp. We'll cook up some wolf meat, have a little meal. It'll be great. I'm doing a lot of, like, pseudo-partial RPing right now between this and my new Skyrim modded stream on Tuesdays and Thursdays. I like it. I do enjoy RPing, and I don't do enough of it on the channel. You know, sticking to a role. Oh, we got a hunt. We've got a glowing one there. Let's take him down. Oh, I did nothing. He's mad. Okay, that did more. There we go, and he's down. We're cautioned. Let's reload before another one comes in. Where's that other red stag? We gotta get that prime. Oh, it's a yearling. Nah. We'll leave it be. We'll take the hide, you know? The whole thing on that note. Wanted to make sure people were, you know, collecting their hides. Alright, well, I mean, we killed its parent. We really should put it out of its misery. Hi, I'm sorry about that. Oh, it's just... oh, I can't. I'm sorry, you're probably gonna die of the elements now that I've killed your parent there. I'm an awful human being. Alright, so we've got a tunnel that looks definitely blocked off. Okay, anything here? Lake house key! We got a key to a lake house. Oh my god, we really gotta... I mean, I was already going to look for the lake, but now I want to even more. Anything else in these things? Nope. Alright. Alright, well, we'll come to the crossroads here, because, yeah, that looks like more end of the world over there. So, yeah, we'll go back to camp. And actually, you know what? If we're heading to the lake, maybe we pick up camp. I'll leave the beacon there. Just so that we can come back here for resources if we need, because there is a lot of stuff here. But let's head back up, cook up some meat, have a nice meal, and then go to bed and start the morning anew. Lovely. All right. Let us... there we go. Cooking pot. I'm in combat? I probably should have killed that deer. Oh, wait, nope, we're out of combat. Cool. All right, let's roast ourselves up some grilled rad stag. There we go. Ooh, all four, nice. That'll be great, too. More carry capacity? Excellent. Rad short. No, I don't really feel like doing that one. You know what? I'm gonna have a steak. There we go. Let's cook up that Brahmin meat from wherever I got that. And, alright. Okay, let's take a little seat here. Sit down. There we go. Lovely. Enjoy the fire. Who doesn't love sitting by a fire, having some meat, out camping? It's wonderful. And God, I haven't been camping in months. I should go. Granted, reason why is I don't camp in the summer. It's too darn hot. I only camp in fall and winter. I don't like heat. Where was that? There it is, ribeye steak. Lovely. Ah, delicious. Delicious. All right, well, let's go to bed, then we'll pack up camp in the morning and head on out. There we go, pull tent, and we'll sleep. We'll sleep for 10 hours. Yeah, there we go, there we go. Yeah, I should start planning my fall camping trip. Head into the mountains, definitely. Definitely head into the mountains. Grey Garden suffered an attack. Oh no! What a shame. Alright, let's pack up. Alright, remove lantern. Pick up tent. Oh, my fire burnt out! No! Oh god, do I actually have to refill that thing? Oh no. I didn't. Again, I haven't used this in so long. Pick up. Oh no, it is! Oh no! We may not have another fire, guys! Oh, it's the chemistry station I need. Oh no! Oh, I didn't. I should have expected the fire to have a timer on it, but I haven't used the campfire mod in so long. God, yeah, we don't have a chemistry station in here. Yeah, there's no chemistry station. Alright, well, let's get out onto the trail. Hopefully, at the lake house, we'll find a chem station that we can use. And, yeah, let's just hit up the main road here, follow it till we hopefully find the lake. We have a lake house key, and that'll be my goal for today. Get to the lake, find the lake house, and that lake house will be our new little home. I mean, we still got camping equipment we'll carry around for when we're out and about, but, you know, a nice lake house would be good. I mean, who wouldn't want a lake house? I would kill for a lake house. Almost had one. When I was looking for a house to buy a couple years back, I almost bought this, it was a small little house, but it wasn't far from my work at the time, and it was like, oh god, what's it called? Oh, I'm forgetting the style, the like, A-frame sort of chalet-style house. It was on a small lake. It was tiny, but, oh, it would have been wonderful. I could have just tossed my kayak right out in the water there. It would have been great. But a house flipper had a higher bid. Bought out the thing from right under me. Dang. All right, so that's some sort of weird insect thing over here. We got a gas station. What do we got? We got some fuel, plenty of gas. Ooh, God, don't step in it. Jeez. Oh, and one of you guys actually said that I might have been able to climb up that tree back at the town, but I would have been more slow about it. I forgot about that. We were going to try that. But oh well, we'll try it another time. All right, so I was really hoping the lake would be just here. Let's actually get on top of this thing, see if we can get a bit higher of a view. Because I'd really... Oh! That looks like lake. That looks like lake! Yes. All right, let's also still, though, see if we can get a better view. Can I get up this? I can. Yes. All right, can we spot the lake house? Ooh, we got a communication array over there. That might be where the lake house is. No, I don't see anything. Oh, that might be the lake house through the trees there. It's kind of hard to tell with the trees, but I think that might be it. Anything out that way? Yeah, this looks like more rocks. Open land for hunting. Lots of annoying bloat flies. Alright, I'm gonna ignore that whole noise right now because I don't want to deal with that. I hate having to shoot bugs. We're actually gonna beeline across. through the woods over this way and try and make it to... Yeah, I think that's got to be the lakeside cabin. We'll link up with the road here in a second. I just want to avoid the flying things. You guys know me. I always have a hard time hitting those darn things. Let's head over here. Yeah, this would definitely be an interesting map if you did play survival kind of game. Added on all that stuff, plus, you know, using some hardcore mods for things. Oh, hey, that was like a thing. Is it, is it fully loaded in? Oh no, guys, I think the mod just crashed. Yep. Oh, wait, oh, nope, we're good, we're in, it all loaded. So the mod was just taking a whole lot of time to load up Lake Splendid. Oh my god, yes. I didn't even see these cars before when we were trying to load in. That was jarring. I really thought we were going to lose the whole thing there for a moment, but we're good. The game was not crashing. It was just trying to deal with this. Alright, well let's... Oh boy, that's some... I don't think I want to drink out of that water pump. I mean, I know that's just a missing texture, but still. You know, I don't want to get too close to the lake, honestly. Oh, hey, a boat just popped in. Just in case, you know, it spawns something. All right, that's an expert. Yeah, we'll go through all these next time. So let's find the lake house. I mean, that honestly could be it, but I'm going to think it's not, though. Why can't I sprint now? Am I over-encumbered? No? What? The game's not letting me sprint anymore. Oh, yeah, I forgot about the bug repellent. I wonder if we could have used that and the flying things would have stayed away. Yeah, ever since the game just, like, lurched back into existence, I can't sprint anymore. What? Hey, lake house key! Perfect! Alright, so this is going to be a good place to end today. Let's head on inside, check out our new home. And then we're going to folder, overdue books. Yeah, let's check this place out. See if there's anything fun in here first. The next time, gnome, we'll explore the rest of the houses. Oh, God, I need a chemistry station. Oh, really? The key doesn't work on the back door? Alright. Really? Oh, a little bit more? There we go.
Nice.
I mean, not exactly the house I was hoping for here. I mean, we don't even have enclosed walls, but I guess it's a roof over our head. I guess it is that. Oh, so we really didn't need the key, did we? We could have just gone through the back door that we could pick. Oh, I wish this was a chemistry station. Oh, I need a chemistry station to build more fire things. Maybe there's one in here somewhere. I don't know. But all right, so this is going to be a good place to end for today. Next episode, we'll go and investigate all these houses and see what potential more lore there is. I'm definitely taking that Gwinnett Ale. And then maybe check out that communication array that's on the other side of the lake. That could be interesting. Well, that's going to be it for this one, folks. Hopefully you all have enjoyed and you do come back for the next fish. But until that time, thank you for watching, and as always, have a good one.